Science Summary. A study shows that the impact that caused the mass extinction of the dinosaurs gave rise to the Amazon rainforest as it's known today. Pollen and leaf fossils show that neotropical rainforests like it transitioned from widely spaced forests of mostly cone-bearing plants to flowering trees with thick canopies, which block sunlight on the forest floor. The forest biomes acquired sophisticated vertical layering and, over time, had their species composition replaced. The recovery to former levels of plant diversity took about 6 million years. A study finds that carbon emissions from Bitcoin mining in China have accelerated rapidly and are about to exceed total annual carbon emissions of countries like Italy or Spain. A majority of this cryptocurrency mining is located within China and largely fueled by non-renewable sources. Authors of the peer-reviewed document show that energy consumption can be expected to be ranked 12th among all countries within about 3 years, and that it therefore interferes with climate change mitigation commitments. The Bitcoin software uses a proof-of-work function, by which computers running it generate current economic value. It ensures that a list or block of recent transfers of Bitcoin money has not been manipulated, and does so by functions that are designed for only one purpose, requiring lots of computation. Scientists show that the brains of early Homo from Africa and a site in Georgia retained a great ape-like structure of the frontal lobe for far longer than previously thought, until about 1.5 million years ago. Their findings imply that Homo erectus first dispersed out of Africa before human brains evolved to roughly their modern anatomical structure, in terms of the location and organization of individual brain regions. It also shows that this evolution occurred not during, but only long after the Homo lineage evolved, about 2.5 million years ago, and after they, Homo erectus in particular, evolved to walk upright. News outlets report that the first house, 3D printed out of clay, has been completed. The two modules of the prototype, called Tekla, was printed by two large synchronized arms that used a mix of locally sourced clay, soil, water, and other materials. Future iterations of the buildings could be extremely cheap, well insulated, and highly weatherproof, while they could get produced rapidly and require only very little easily learnable manual labor and relatively little energy. They may be used to reduce homelessness, increase living standards, reduce carbon emissions from concrete, help enable autonomous eco-villages, and enable the provision of housing for victims of natural disasters and for migrants near their homes. Scientists report the discovery of a billion-years-old fossilized life form with differentiated multicellularity, microorganisms composed of two different types of cells. This shows that the evolution of having multiple cells of different types, as in animal lineages, had already evolved 1 billion years ago. Furthermore, the eukaryote, that is not an animal, plant, or fungi, also strengthens the theory that key phases of the evolution of animals occurred in freshwater lakes rather than in or at the ocean. On Mars, NASA's helicopter drone Ingenuity performs the first powered aircraft flight on another planet in human history. The solar-powered helicopter has a communications link with the rover Perseverance and uses autonomous control during its short flights, which are scripted by operators on Earth. It marks the second controlled flight on another planet after the Soviet Union's unpowered balloon flight on Venus in 1985. The robot could be used to scout locations of interest for planning the rover's driving routes, to test its novel technologies, and for aerial photography or mapping. Scientists report that of about 39 million groundwater wells, 6 to 20% are at high risk of running dry if groundwater levels decline, or, as with many areas, and possibly more than half of major aquifers, continue to decline. They found that up to every fifth well of this type is no deeper than 5 meters below its local water table. As billions rely on drinking water and agriculture by such wells, unmitigated disruptions due to overpumping, drought, and climate change may cause violent conflicts and waves of climate refugees. While drilling deeper wells is currently expensive, several options for managing groundwater sustainably, such as regulations and water efficiency technologies, already exist. A team of scientists presents rough spectral signatures of about 1,000 molecules that may be involved in the production or consumption of phosphine in planetary atmospheres. In September 2020, scientists reported the detection of phosphine on Venus, which indicated the presence of life there. The new dataset of the molecular signatures, which was created via computational quantum chemistry, could help prevent misidentifications of molecules in telescopic data, such as data about the light spectrum of Venus. It could also get used in future detections and identifications of atmospheric molecules, for which it may help trace how certain chemicals are produced or consumed. A news report informs about a NASA-funded mission to design and test robotic balloons for future exploration of Venus. A group of scientists who first reported the detection of likely biosignature phosphine on Venus publishes a preprint recovering the ALMA telescope detection of monophosphine of specific concentrations there, which was challenged by critical studies. They also show it was not misidentified sulfur dioxide, as suggested by other scientists. Scientists report that there appears to be an almost 50% higher rate of neurological and psychiatric diseases during the following 6 months after COVID-19 infections than after infections with flu viruses. 34% of people were diagnosed with such diseases during that time, and about 13% received their first such diagnosis. A study shows that consistently meeting scientific guidelines of 150 or more minutes per week of exercise or similar physical activity substantially decreased the risk of hospitalization and death due to COVID-19, even when considering likely risk factors such as elevated BMI. The CDC reports 5,800 COVID-19 infections, also called breakthrough infections, in people fully vaccinated with mRNA vaccines. Without vaccines that have an efficacy of 100%, such cases were expected. Their data also shows that 7% of these patients required hospitalization. Another team of scientists report that of about 400 fully vaccinated persons, 2 women had breakthrough infections and identify their variants' viral mutations. Scientists report, to date unexplained, results of experiments about quantum mechanical effects on the subatomic particle called muon that challenge the standard model of physics. The NOAA reports the largest recorded annual increase in methane emissions in 2020 despite pandemic lockdown. Biological sources of methane, such as wetlands or livestock, appear to be the major factor of the increase, which could be the result of a self-reinforcing feedback effect of global warming. A study finds that individual humans engaged in problem-solving tend to overlook subtractive changes, including those that are critical elements of efficient solutions. This tendency to solve only by creating or adding elements is shown to intensify with higher cognitive loads, such as information overload. Scientists confirm, with ancient genomic data, that initial European modern humans mixed with Neanderthals, with there being continuity to later people in Eurasia, and report that such admixture appears to have been far more common than previously thought. The company Neuralink publishes a video of a monkey with two brain implants playing a mind-controlled version of Pong. While similar technology has been demonstrated for roughly two decades, and wireless implants have existed for years, some observers note that the organization increased the number of implanted electrodes that are read wirelessly. Scientists present a DARPA-funded tool for epigenome editing that can heritably suppress the gene expression of most genes, multiple genes at once, and can have these changes easily reversed. Gene expression is the process in which functional proteins are built according to instructions encoded in DNA. This construction is altered by the more dynamic epigenomes. Scientists develop a prototype and design rules for so-called both sides contacted silicon solar cells, with conversion efficiencies of 26% and above, Earth's highest for this type of solar cell. For the first time, an astronomer publicly describes how one could search for quantum communication transmissions sent by extraterrestrial intelligence using existing telescope and receiver technology. He also provides arguments for why future searches of SETI should also target interstellar quantum communications. Scientists report the creation of the first human-monkey hybrid embryos. They injected monkey embryos with human stem cells and let them develop for 19 days. The hybrids, also known as chimeras in mythology, could enable better tests of life-saving medicine, important biotech research, and growing transplantable human organs. However, the results of the controversial study indicate that most embryos did not survive longer than 15 days, and it has been argued that such primates are very small and take too long to develop for these purposes. Equivalent alternatives to such hybrids may be possible, and a better option due to several needs and options-dependent ethical issues. Scientists report that in the specific case of Alaska's boreal forests, the recovery from wildfires shifted the forests to a mix of trees that stores about 5 times more carbon than previously, which could offset the carbon emitted during the fires. The rover Perseverance converts carbon dioxide into oxygen for the first time on Mars. Scientists show that a class of warp drives that are slower than light could control the rate of time within the spaceship and are sourced from positive energy could, in principle, possibly be constructed based on known physical principles. Furthermore, they provide a new argument for why warp drives that are faster than light would always violate weak energy conditions and find that the warp drive concept proposed in a study published in March likely forms a new class of warp drive spacetimes. The University of Oxford reports the development and early trials results of a malaria vaccine with 77% efficacy after 1 year, the first to meet the World Health Organization's goal of 75% efficacy. The first core module of the Chinese Tiangong space station is placed in low Earth orbit. It is one of 3 permanent modules intended to be fully assembled in 2022 for a designed lifespan of 10 to 15 years, is about 17 meters in size, and could host 3 astronaut scientists.